Hey friends, welcome back to another video. I hope you are doing well, whatever part of the world you are currently residing in. This video is talking about an online file transfer service called MASV, which will help you as a filmmaker collaborate with other creatives around the world, particularly if you are sending large files such as raw footage or ProRes or uncompressed DNX HD footage from your beautiful cinema cameras. For me and our production company, over the years we've collaborated with lots of people outside of our country, and we've contracted filmmakers to shoot footage for us, and we've also been editors for external production companies. And so the transfer of files is really commonplace for us in our industry, but the biggest issue is getting footage from A to B. What you obviously have to do is purchase a hard drive, copy all of the footage onto a hard drive, go to a courier company, get it air freighted to New Zealand, then it goes through New Zealand customs, and then eventually it'll arrive here. So it could be weeks before we see the footage here, and it also will cost quite a bit of money to purchase the hard drive and send it down here. Over the years, we've been a part of a lot of projects where we've transferred files using hard drives, and it has honestly been really difficult to manage. And so today I'm really excited to talk about MASV, an online file transfer service which allows you to transfer data anywhere in the world really quickly, up to 15 terabytes at a time. Now I have to mention that this video is sponsored by MASV, which I'm really stoked about for two reasons. The first one is this is the first sponsorship for this YouTube channel, so I'm really thankful to MASV for believing in this small channel. It's really great to see this channel growing in terms of its reach around the world. But the second reason is that I'm genuinely excited about this product because it solves a really big problem for me and my production company. I'm only ever going to recommend products to you guys that one, I genuinely believe in, and two, I'm utilizing in my own workflow that solves a genuine need and problem for my video production business. So let's jump in and take a look at how you could utilize MASV within your workflow. So to begin with MASV, you can follow the link in the description of this video to start your free trial and gain 100 gigabytes of free download. After that, it is pay as you go, and I just want to highlight quickly for you the pricing of this service. It is 25 cents per gigabyte of download, and you can go ahead and pre-purchase gigabytes if you would like to do it that way. So 500 gigabytes for $125. I do want to talk about the pricing at the end of this video, so make sure you stick around for that. If you want to know anything about MASV, there are tons of features that you can read on the website. It's really well documented and really well explained. What you can also do over on the main page under features is click desktop app and go ahead and download the desktop app. That's the great thing about this service, is it's not just a web interface, and the desktop app is a really secure way of working. And what you can see, I've actually already started to send a package which is uploading to my MASV account as we speak. One thing I do want to point out to you is the upload speed here. Now my internet connection at home is about 400 megabytes upload and download at any one time because we are on a fiber connection. But as you can see, MASV is utilizing that entire internet connection and saturating it for my upload speed. So I think the most common way we'll be utilizing MASV within our workflow is to give a portal link to collaborators around the world to send us footage. In the interface, once you've logged in and created an account, there's a portal tab here, and you can go ahead and add a new portal. Simply just fill out the details here, create a domain name, and what you'll end up with is your own custom portal URL. So the domain name is joshuakirk.portal.massive.app, and you can see here, this is what the web interface looks like. You can use the web interface, but what you can also do is copy the portal link and send it to anyone who has downloaded the MASV application for desktop. I'm going to go ahead and paste in my portal URL and click continue. And then simply, all the collaborator needs to do, no matter where they are in the world, is to simply drag and drop the files into this Dropbox and click send. What that's going to do is upload to my personal portal, and once that file is completely uploaded, I will get a notification on my end that the file has been successfully uploaded, and then I will be able to download that to my server. So the portal is a great way for you to send a link out to external collaborators just to receive footage from overseas. So the second way we can use MASV is obviously to send files ourselves. So sending files from our end, uploading it to the MASV server for other people to download. Now, the way the pricing works with MASV is you only pay for the footage that you download. So you can have people from all over the world upload footage to your portal, but it's not until you download that footage to your server that you're actually paying for it. So if people make a mistake and upload the wrong files, you won't be paying for that until you actually download it to your server. So now this 57.22 gigabyte file has been successfully uploaded. It took roughly about 15 to 20 minutes to upload. I can go ahead and show the link, and I can just simply copy this link and paste it into a web browser, hit enter, and you can see this is what a recipient would receive. You can see here you can download it directly in the browser, but better yet, if someone who is receiving this file simply downloads the desktop application, what you can do is go ahead and copy this link. And then if you have the desktop application open, you can click receive, and then you can paste that URL into the app. You can see here the file is represented, and you can choose your downloads folder here. Go ahead and click download. Once again, you can see that MASV is saturating my download speed, and the ETA for this download is approximately 22 minutes for close to a 60 gigabyte file. So overall, so far, my experience with MASV has been a really positive one. The ease of use using the MASV application for desktop, just the way you can send a file really easily, receive a file, or allow collaborators to send files to your personal portal, is a really beautiful way of working. And I can just imagine how this is going to increase speed and efficiency for our productions moving forward. Now, reading up a little bit more about MASV, there are a ton of features that are under the hood that you could utilize. But for me and my video production company, we're really just interested in getting footage from A to B and B to A. So when we're collaborating with filmmakers around the world and around the country, we simply just want to be able to upload footage really quickly, download footage really quickly, and it's as simple as that. We essentially want a service that replaces the old school hard drive and shipping the hard drive through a courier. And MASV to me seems like a really viable solution to that problem. So there you have it, guys. If you are interested in this for yourself, you can click on the link in the video description below to access a free trial with 100 gigabytes for free. Beyond that point, it is pay as you go. Now, to be honest, the pay as you go fee put me off at first. I'm really conditioned to these whole monthly subscriptions, you know, $10, $15, $20 a month. So when I saw the cost of a per gigabyte download, I was a little bit taken back, but after some consideration, I realized that MASV is a really professional tool, and with professional tools come professional features. So the connection's super stable, the speed of upload and download saturates your internet connection, the whole infrastructure of their service is a really professional tool for you to utilize. Hey, so I hope this video was helpful for you. If you enjoyed it, please make sure to subscribe and like on this video, or leave a comment in the description of this video and I'll be sure to jump on and answer any questions. Are you still using hard drives? What are the benefits, the pros and cons? Let's start a discussion in the comment box below. But for now, peace out, and we will see you in the next video.